Organizations need to support business growth and expansion quickly and easily. Often, the business processes involved are complex for both experienced and new employees. PeopleSoft Fluid General Ledger Business Unit Management enables you to add general ledger and business units, copy existing units and ledgers, and maintains existing units through a simple and intuitive activity guide, increasing efficiency and control. Let's log into the system and tap the GL Business Units tile. In cases of expansion or acquisition, customers need to add new business units based on existing business entities. The easiest and quickest way to do that is to copy from one of those business entities. Using the GL Business Units page, you can search for an existing business unit and select that business unit from your search results. When you use the search function in the left pane, you can specify the business unit or choose the list type options like All, Favorite, and Recent Updates. Let's create a new business unit by copying an existing business unit. This new business unit has the same attributes and setup as the source BU. To copy, tap Actions and tap Copy. The system shows you a questionnaire about the new entity. You can choose yes or no for each question. Based on your answer, the system creates steps to guide you in the creation process. The questionnaire streamlines the setup process for you in a single location. All of the definitions are retained from the business unit that you're copying. You only need to add the required information for the new entity and update the definitions that are different from the source BU. The first two questions are used to add a ledger and ledger group. You can also indicate if you're using summary ledger reporting. In this example, since we've copied an existing business unit, we're answering no to all of the questions. Once you're done, tap Next. On the left side of the GL Business Units page, you can see the activity guide created by the system based on your answers. At the top of the page, you can see a message informing you that this business unit is a copy of the source business unit you selected. The steps in the activity guide are shown in the order that you should complete them. You can switch between steps once you've finished entering information in a step. Mandatory steps are marked by a red asterisk. When a step is selected, its definition appears on the right pane. The status below each step shows you where you are in the process. On the basic information step, you need to update all of the information for the new business unit, such as the name, description, as of date, and base currency. After entering the details, tap Save. When you save, the step is marked as complete. Now, you're ready to connect ledger groups to the newly created business unit. Tap Next. Tap the Assign Ledger Group button. You can see a modal window showing a list of ledger groups. Select the ledger groups and tap Done. Once the ledger groups are assigned to the new business unit, add the calendar ID and check the Journal Generator default box. Checkboxes under the Select column indicate how you can update the ledger options. If only one is checked, you can choose to update one ledger group at a time. Alternatively, you can select multiple entries and update them all at once. Tap Save. Tap Next. The next step is related to ledger options. Here, you can update the recording and reporting ledger groups all at once for each of the ledger options steps. You can switch between these steps at any time. Use the menu in the top right corner of the page to navigate to different options in order to mark a step complete or mark various steps complete. You can also return to the questionnaire and change your answers, or navigate back to the home page. Tap Next to go to the Journal Edit Options step. This step also allows you to link any combination editing group to ledger groups. In this example, a balance sheet exception combination editing group is needed for the recording ledger group. Tap Save. Swipe down and tap the GL Open Period Update step. You can review the GL Open Period for recording ledger group and update the current open period in the To Period field. Once done, tap Next. You can also add a searchable log to document any changes you made. Tap Next. The last step in the activity guide is Submit to Complete. This concludes the process of adding a general ledger business unit using the copy feature. For business unit acquisition and expansion activities that are different from your existing operating entities, you can choose to add the new entity from the beginning or modify a copied entity through the same questionnaire, but with different responses. Let's review the questionnaire by initiating another copy action. Tap Yes for all four questions, and then tap Next. You can see a second set of questions. This is from the Advanced Features question from the first questionnaire page. The system takes all of these attributes from the source business unit. You only have to update these business unit level options on an as-needed basis. Tap Next. Here, you can see additional sections that are shown in the activity guide. These sections or steps are related to Create New Ledger, Create New Ledger Group, Advanced Features, and Summary Ledger Sets. Normally, these sections are hidden unless you choose to display them through the questionnaire. Tap Basic Information and enter the new business unit name, update the description and currency. Tap Save. Finally, in the Advanced Features section, there are individual steps that can be updated. These advanced features are at the business unit level rather than at the ledger unit level. These options don't typically change once they're established. The PeopleSoft Fluid General Ledger Business Unit provides you with options to add and manage general ledger business units quickly and easily, saving time and effort. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.